Hello, everybody, and I hope you're having a blessed day. And I just want to share a couple of tips with you today. I think that access to food is going to be very little or none at all. Now, that's just what I believe. And the other day, I have some jalapenos, and I like to take jalapenos and fry them in a little bit of lard. You can use oil if you want, until they're kind of toasty and brown on the outside, and then I like to eat them with some refried beans and a couple of fried eggs. Well, I got to noticing that the jalapenos were starting to turn wrinkled, and that was a sign that they were going to go bad on me. And so I have a salsa that I make and I freeze, but I usually do an enormous amount of jalapenos when I make this salsa. Now, I have the recipe to that salsa. You can go back and look. As a matter of fact, I have quite a few of really good videos on storing food and putting food away. But I decided I would go ahead and boil those jalapenos. Now, this is a jar. I took it out of the freezer so I could show it to you, so you can see the ice on it. But it's a pint jar that I actually was able to get from those small amount of jalapenos that I have, that if I had not have done this, they would have went bad on me and I would have lost them completely. So this gives me an extra jar of salsa that I love to put over tacos, different things, mostly tacos, okay? Today, I'm going to work with these potatoes. Remember I did a video on, you know, finding the coolest place in your house if you don't have a, what do they call it? A root cellar. Thank you. I couldn't think of the name. A root cellar. And I don't have one. And I noticed that my restroom was the coolest room in my home. And so I started storing potatoes there 40, 50, 60 pounds at a time when they're on sale. But I got to noticing, because it's been 4 months they've been in my restroom, I saw a lot of these. And they're kind of soft when you push on them. You see, I have more over here that's got some of the eyes are already falling off. I've had them on the table. But anyhow, I decided I needed to do something with these. So what I'm going to do then is I'm going to take the potatoes and I'm just going to start peeling them. I'm not going to worry. You know, these potatoes are kind of soft. They really are. But I'm just going to peel all the skins off of these and any of the bad spots I find in them. You see like that right there? Just gonna cut them out, you know. But I'm gonna keep doing this because what I'm gonna do is I'm actually just gonna cube these up, cover them with water. Of course, I'll rinse them after I get them peeled, and then I'm gonna cover them with water, and then I'm gonna cook them until they're nice and tender, and then I'll drain the water off of these, and then I will take and put them in a bowl. And I will mash them with a potato masher or bean masher, but mash them. Not whip them, not with an electric mixer, but just mash them. I'm not going to put anything in them. I'm just going to mash them up. And I'm going to let them completely cool. And after they cool, I will set them in a bag, Ziploc bags. I'll put them in there to use to make things like potato pancakes. You know, those little potato pancakes everybody loves so much. And also, if you go back and you'll see in one of my videos where I show you how to use potatoes and a can of tuna fish, the mashed potatoes that you mix tuna fish in with it, and you make a meal out of it. And that's what I'm gonna do with this. That's why I decided I would do this, is because I don't want to lose anything when it comes to food, not even the smallest amount. Like I said, I think we're heading for some very, very serious trouble in the future. And I think that accessibility to food is going to be very scarce. And so every little bit that I can do that will give me an extra meal or a couple of extra meals or even a seasoning to a meal, I'm trying to make sure that I have no waste to it. So this is just another idea, you know. If you've got potatoes that look like this, you know, that's got all these little eyes on them, of course, they're sitting here and I move them and they fall, and they may be even, you know, wrinkly, soft looking, it don't matter. Just use them before they become so soft that they rot. But use them, boil them, mash them, cool them, put them in a Ziploc bag, flatten the Ziploc bag out, you know, so it doesn't take up a lot of space in your freezer. That way you can get more in there or add more when you get another bag of potatoes. But I hope this is helpful. We need to do as much as we possibly can to help ourselves in case access to food becomes even worse than it is. I have a family member that travels the 50 states, and in a lot of those places, he sees a lot of problems with food in those different areas. Now, your area may not, you may be fine. But then later, you might not be fine, and you may have difficulties. So every little bit we can do helps. And I will be putting more things out. And anybody that's new, thank you for stopping by. I appreciate it. And I appreciate all of you that watch. And I hope you find it helpful. And you're all in my prayers, because we're going to need it. But God bless, and have a blessed day.